You're watching the Croydon Islamic Community Trust channel.
It doesn't have to, for example, be that's constant remembrance of Allah. So that is something which protects a person from the shaitan. And there's a hadith that mentions where the Messenger of Allah said, "Amarukum bi dhikrillah kathira." I order you to remember Allah a lot. "Amarukum bi dhikrillah kathira." وإن مثل ذلك كمثل رجل طلبه العدو. The example of the remembrance of Allah is like the example of a person who's being sought by his enemy. His enemy's after him, an army. He is after him. So he's fleeing. And he flees to a fortress that he protects himself and he uses as a protection from the enemy. Then that person is a person that's protecting himself there. Then that's like the servant who protects himself with the remembrance of Allah. I.e. that's like the same as the person. So I said the similitude and give an example of the dhikr of Allah, the remembrance of Allah, is like the example of a person who has an enemy after him and the enemy can't reach him because he's protecting himself by a fortress. So the dhikr of Allah is a fortress. It protects a person from the shaitan. The shaitan is an enemy. He's an avowed enemy. He's not just an enemy, he's taken a vow with Allah to be an enemy to mankind. So a person protects himself from the enemy of the shaitan by having constant remembrance of Allah. The constant remembrance of the adhkar of the morning and the evening, the adhkar that a person makes when he leaves the house and comes in the house, the adhkar that a person makes when he gets in his car and he drives his car, the adhkar that a person makes when he eats and when he has relations with his wife, all the different times that the adhkar is mentioned, the person makes the adhkar, then that's a protection from shaitan. If a person doesn't make adhkar when he has relations with his wife, then shaitan is with him. If he doesn't make adhkar when he eats, then shaitan is eating with him. If he doesn't make adhkar when at certain times of Maghrib, for example, coming in and going out, then he's opening his door to shaitan. So it's a protection for a person from the devil. And the devil is an enemy to us. So if a person knows he's confronting an enemy, how does he go out? Does he go out without a weapon? Does he go out without a sword, a shield, without armor? Does he go out by himself? No, he calls up all his friends. He says, "Look, there's an enemy at my doors, come around." And he calls, so is he by himself or is he in a group? He's in a group. He's in a group of anyone else, he's in a group of people that are also like him, that are prepared to defeat and overcome an enemy. They come with weapons, they come armed, they come prepared, they don't come just empty-handed. The devil is a bigger enemy than an enemy that you'd be facing in front of you. He's a bigger enemy because his aim is to misguide you from the straight path. The enemy, your enemy's aim is to defeat you, to cause you bodily harm. The harm that your body endures is less harmful than the harm that your soul will endure when it's misguided by the devil. If your body can be injured but your iman is intact, alhamdulillah, you're safe. Your iman is injured but your body is intact, then you're misguided. It doesn't have any benefit for you. So be careful of the ways of the devil. And one of the ways to protect yourself from the devil is constant remembrance of Allah. If a person constantly remembers Allah, then the moment he sees something which he knows is displeasing to Allah, he says, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitan ar-rajim." I seek refuge in Allah from the devil. That's what he's going to say. He's going to close his eyes. The fifth way is sticking to the jama'ah. Sticking to the jama'ah means that a person isn't by themselves. Because if a person is by themselves, their company is shaitan, the devil. So if a person is always by themselves, you find that they're accompanied by the shaitan. So if a person is traveling or a person is going places, person should have company, good company, not any company either. Because you find from amongst people are also shayateen. They are shayateen min al-ins. They are devils from amongst people. I.e. they say he's a devil in or a wolf in sheep's clothing. So you have a devil in human form. In the sense that he looks like a friend. He seems to be friendly, but in reality he's a devil. Why? Because all he wants to do is haram. All he wants to speak about is haram. The ways that he wants to follow are drinking, smoking, gambling, taking drugs, listening to music, checking women, going out to clubs. That's his ways. These ways are the ways of the devils, they're not the ways of the... It's not the Surah al-Mustaqeem. Drinking khamar is haram. It's from the ways of the devil. It causes disunity and firqa and causes arguments and other things. Gambling is from the ways of the devil. Gambling as well, because it's been made easy for people online. You don't even have to go anywhere now. The internet is a door to evil. The internet is an opening and it's a window to evil. It brings the dunya to you. All of it, you don't have to go anywhere. It brings everything to you where you are. Every evil you can imagine, you don't have to go out for it now. It's come to you in the form of the internet. Gambling, buying drink. Before, you had to go out to buy drink. So a person, a Muslim, might feel ashamed to go to the off-license because he's not going to pick up khamar. Now he doesn't have to go out, he can order it to his house, no one knows anything. Shaitan, him and Shaitan alone, that's it. Drinking. You might as well have two cups, one for him and one for Shaitan, you might as well fill it up. Because he's not drinking by himself. Gambling as well, same thing. First you used to have to go out to a betting shop and bet in a shop. A Muslim might feel a bit of shyness to go into a shop or to go into a club. Now he doesn't have to do that. He can open the internet and they'll give him money to gamble. They'll give you your first £5, your first £10 to place a bet. Look at the temptation, look at the Shaitan. He's attacking. Here's £5, free money. Just place a bet. And in most times, the first bet you're going to win. Why? Because Shaitan wants you to continue betting. He's not going to make you lose, but make you win. Why? Because you're betting with Shaitan. It's you and Shaitan now. So the internet is a window to evil. Don't be in any doubt. See the internet as an enemy that you have to protect yourself and your family from it. From the evils of the internet as well as music. Before you had to go, you had to buy. You had to pay money, you had to go out, you had to go to a shopping to buy music, for example. Now you don't have to pay for anything, download it from the internet. You don't even have to, if you don't want to use iTunes, you can download it for free, as everyone knows. Again, a window to evil. It's not a window to good. Without a doubt, the internet is a means. It's an ala, it's a tool. But what it's utilized for, if you look at a percentage of the internet, you'll see 80% or 85% is utilized for things which are haram for Muslims. Not things which are halal for Muslims. Things which are haram for Muslims. The thing which the internet is most used for is pornography. And now that it's on your phone, or on the phones of your children, then it's even more dangerous. Not just for the children, also for the adults as well. So, one of the ways that a person protects himself is by not being alone. Even when it comes to using the internet, not being alone when a person is using the internet. Don't use the internet when you're by yourself. Use it when you're with someone. In the front room with your wife. Don't let the kids use it unless they're in a public place where other people are there, so they're not alone. Because when a person's by himself and his phone, then he's by himself with his Shaitan, that's it. And in most cases, he's not going to use it for beneficial talks and beneficial lectures. He's going to use it to read the news and to catch up, at the least evil, to catch up with the trash gossip of the media and the famous people, for example. What this singer is doing, what that actor is doing, which actor got married to that singer, and stuff like that, in the case of following gossip. And in most cases, the images which he's going to see are not going to be images which are going to, the images are going to do what? Lead the persons to increase their shahawat. Because the images you can see are going to be images of women that are not covered up. Yeah, you see it outside, but it's different when you're by yourself and you're not alone. You're outside in a public place. But when you're by yourself and you're in your phone, then you're alone. Or your phone or your internet or wherever it is. So a person has to not be alone with the internet. Not be alone with Facebook. Where they can have these conversations with women, for example. So avoiding the ways of the devil means not being alone, by being together, by being in the jama'ah. Also, one of the important ways of avoiding the temptations and the distraction of the devil is by avoiding places where you suspect the devil is going to be more active or most active. By avoiding the places where the devil is going to be most active. Like where? Like shopping centres. Shopping centres, what you see here, what people do in there is usually stuff which is haram, unfortunately. You find, for example, in Jahiliyyah, group of boys used to meet up, group of girls used to meet up and used to go to shopping centres. What for? Boys to talk to girls and girls to talk to boys. That was the reason. So you get dressed up and you go to a shopping centre. Why? Because you're bound to find the opposite sex there that you can talk to. Or, if not that, if a person works in those places, then you find it's places of fitna, in the sense of flirting with the opposite sex. If a person works in, for example, retail. Person works in retail, he works in a coffee shop, he works in a clothes shop, he works in a trainer shop, JD Sports, one of these places. You find that it's a place of fitna. Why? Because he's constantly in communication with the opposite sex. And as a result of that, you find that he starts flirting, she starts flirting, taking numbers, swapping numbers, then speaking on the phone, by themselves, meeting up, and stuff like this. So it's places of fitna. I.e., you know that once you go there,